nome assim eu falo assim eu não sei.
I also want to thank God, the leadership of the church, for not giving us grace to stand before the people of God.
Pour l'opportunité qu'il nous donne.
I really want whatever God has determined and proposed will surely come to pass. Last week Sunday, I remember I and Brother Emmanuel were on duty teaching the children.
Le dimanche passé, j'étais
and we were teaching them about God being a great warrior. And that nobody can hinder God whenever he wants to do a thing. Even his friends cannot stop him. So thereafter, after the service, we are planning to do churches to the children's week, to this one, for preparing for today. And we were discussing about who to preach and who are we going to. Then Sister Vicky, maybe because she has been a leader before, was saying, we shouldn't bother ourselves, this is the duty of the elder. Let us just do what's concerned us. Whoever we preach, they know. And it was Sister Grace, in my mind, I was like, today is Sunday. The elders would have given us to preach 2 weeks ago. So I was like, thank God, this cup has passed over me. I didn't agree with them, but in my mind, I was like, they don't know that if you are to preach, they would have told you at least 2 weeks or a month. So that my mind would be really clear and I would not be bothered. When I got to my even raised the issue with my husband, I was like, they don't know that. So Monday left, that Monday, nothing. No, I'm beyond on Tuesday afternoon, I just saw beside
him.
I was like, I was shocked, as if I've never preached in my life. I didn't even say anything, I just took the message to my husband. I thought I was going to get a support. That no, it is too late, you can't preach. And I just showed him the message. I thought he was saying, why are they just sending it today? At least, at most, you will send your message on Friday to the presiding head. I was like, what? I was looking for a support. And he was busting my purpose. So indeed, whatever God has proposed, even his friends cannot stop him. So here we are today. The theme for the children's service, the children's celebration today is being kingdom-minded to raise godly children. We're considering being kingdom-minded. Because actually before we can raise kingdom-minded children, then we ourselves must be kingdom-minded. So our topic for today is being kingdom-minded. I pray that by the end of today's service, the Holy Spirit will help us that we might face that pertain to eternity in Jesus' name. Yes, in that word, in that statement, we actually have three words. But in my PPT, I wrote two words. Later on, I discovered we have three words. Kingdom, mindedness,
Esprit.
And kingdom-minded itself. I believe we all know what is kingdom. When we talk about kingdom, the word kingdom. It is a realm or domain that is controlled by a king or a queen, right? A king or a queen. Or a realm that is being dominated by somebody, and higher authority. And mindedness is having something at heart, having something in your mind. Giving preference to something above others. That is when we are always thinking about a certain thing. That is to have that thing at heart. We are mindful of it. And when we talk about kingdom, we just said being kingdom minded. And we actually have different types of kingdom. We have the kingdom of man.
maintenant le royaume des hommes.
We have the kingdom of devil.
Le royaume du mal.
We have the kingdom of God.
Et le royaume de Dieu.
You know, the kingdom of man is the one of the kingdom on earth that is being ruled by a king.
Le royaume des hommes c'est celui-là qui est sur la terre.
Like normal kings we have in our various countries.
Les rois qu'on a dans nos différents pays.
And the kingdom of the devil is the domain, a life. A society, a realm that is controlled by the devil.
Et le royaume du diable, c'est une société qui est contrôlée par le diable.
The kingdom of God is also used as kingdom of heaven.
Le royaume de Dieu c'est aussi connu comme le royaume.
Where God himself rules.
Où le Seigneur lui-même dirige.
And of these three kingdoms,
the
kingdom of man can either be controlled by the other two.
Le royaume des hommes peut être contrôlé par
the kingdom of devil or the kingdom of
soit le contrôle, soit le royaume de Dieu.
It depends on whoever the man, the king or the queen decides to put his kingdom under.
Ça dépend de quel royaume décide de diriger.
So now today we are considering being kingdom-minded, the kingdom of God, not kingdom of man or kingdom of devil.
Donc aujourd'hui nous considérons avoir la pensée du royaume de Dieu.
The kingdom of God, which is also heaven, which is also the kingdom of heaven.
Le royaume de Dieu est aussi le royaume du ciel.
1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 13 says, for he has rescued us from the kingdom of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his dear son. So this shows us that we have both the kingdom of darkness, which is that of the devil, and the kingdom of God. So the kingdom of God is what we are calling our attention to, that we have to be mindful of, we have to have the kingdom of God at heart.
Bon, le royaume de Dieu, c'est ce que nous avons pour mettre notre attention à.
It's something we have to be thinking about above every other thing.
C'est ce qu'on doit chercher, on doit faire le search pour nous.
Now when we say kingdom-mindedness, what do we now mean?
Donc, lorsqu'on dit avoir la pensée de Dieu, qu'est-ce que
cela veut dire? It means when one is heavenly-minded.
Cela veut dire que l'esprit du royaume, c'est avoir la pensée céleste.
When one is heavenly-minded. You think about things that pertain to heaven. People don't be on earth, but the Bible says we set treasures for ourselves in heaven. Because wherever our treasure is, there will our hearts be. So that means being kingdom-minded means be heavenly-minded.
Donc cela veut dire qu'avoir la pensée du royaume veut dire avoir la pensée du ciel.
We are eternity. We being eternity focused.
C'est être centré sur l'éternité.
Not just living your life as if you have the whole essence of creating us is to live permanently on earth.
Pas de vivre sa vie comme si on a toutes les sens pour vivre sur la terre permanente.
It is being eternity focused. It is when we make the kingdom of God the nucleus of our living.
C'est lorsqu'on fait du royaume de Dieu le noyau de notre existence.
The nucleus means the central point of a thing.
Le noyau veut dire le point central de quelque chose.
The nucleus is like the source of a thing.
Le noyau c'est comme la source de quelque chose.
In biology, I'm sure we have been taught about the nucleus of.
Nous avons parlé du noyau.
It is the nucleus of a cell. It is the center of that cell where its life originates from.
Le noyau du soleil.
Because in physics, we also have nucleus. The nucleus of an electron.
Le noyau d'un électron.
It is the center of it. So this being godly minded means you are making the kingdom of God the nucleus of your living.
Avoir la pensée de Dieu, c'est
it is the essence of the main reason why you are alive. The essence of your creation on earth. Before you think of any other thing, before you even take any step, you actually place it in line with the word of God. Does this thing fit being a kingdom person?
Avant que tu fasses quoi que ce soit, tu dois d'abord te mettre en tête, est-ce que c'est dans le royaume de Dieu?
As a member of the kingdom of God, this I want to do, does it show that I'm living my life pattern according to the kingdom of God?
En tant que membre du royaume de Dieu, est-ce la façon dont je vais vivre le reflète?
It means giving priority to the things that pertain to the kingdom of God.
Ça veut dire donner la priorité aux choses qui appartiennent au royaume de Dieu.
Things that pertain to heavenly, that pertain to God himself.
Les choses qui appartiennent aux choses.
We give it priority.
Nous donnons à la priorité.
It shows that we are kingdom minded.
Que
we are heavenly conscious. Because if we actually want to raise kingdom minded children, we ourselves have to be kingdom minded. Because we cannot give what we don't have.
Si nous voulons éduquer les enfants afin qu'ils aient la pensée du royaume, nous devons nous-mêmes avoir la pensée du royaume parce qu'on ne peut pas leur donner ce qu'ils n'ont pas.
Kingdom mindedness means striving to make the kingdom of God advance, to the advancement of the kingdom of God.
Avoir la pensée du royaume, c'est-à-dire fournir des efforts pour l'avancement du royaume de Dieu.
Striving towards depopulating the kingdom of hell and populating the kingdom of God.
se bat pour la population du royaume de Dieu.
It is not just about activities we do in church.
Ce n'est pas seulement les activités.
It is not about how many number of ministries that you have.
It is not about
how much you can sing.
Ce n'est pas comment tu peux chanter.
It is not about how much visitation you can do.
Ce n'est pas combien de visitations.
It is not even about how much evangelism you can do. If the purpose of doing all this it is not for the advancement of the kingdom of God, then it is a waste.
Si le but de ce que tu fais dans la maison de Dieu n'est pas pour le royaume de Dieu, alors c'est une peine.
Because sometimes you are so consumed with activities in church, consumed with things that we think we are working for God, but in the reverse, it is not actually expanding the kingdom of God.
Parce que parfois on est tellement consumé par les activités de l'église qu'on pense qu'on est en train de vivre avec le royaume de Dieu, mais en fait c'est au contraire à cela.
Sometimes we do things out of self.
Souvent on fait des choses par nous-mêmes.
To really show that I'm there.
Pour montrer
que show that I'm working.
Pour
to show that I can do this. If they say you should carry a chair before you know it, you are there. Big this paper before you know it, you are there. So that they will see that, oh, I'm very active in the church. In case I need referees, they will say, yes, I know that sister, she comes to Bible study, and she's very active in church. That is not for the expansion of the kingdom of God. It doesn't show that we have the kingdom of God at heart. Being kingdom-minded at times, people might not even notice your service.
Avoir la pensée du royaume, parfois les personnes ne vont pas reconnaître ton
it might only be between you and God.
Ça va être seulement entre toi et Dieu.
You know, there are some silent laborers that you don't know their, you might not see their importance in church.
Il y a certaines personnes qui travaillent dans le silence et
yes, there are those who are contributing to the populating the kingdom of God.
Et il y a ceux-là qui contribuent à la publicité du royaume de Dieu.
So kingdom-mindedness goes beyond our activities in church.
Donc, avoir la pensée du royaume va au-delà de l'activité de l'église.
It goes beyond how much we are engrossed with doing things. It is actually when we have the heart to expand the kingdom of God.
C'est lorsqu'on a le cœur pour pouvoir expandre le royaume de Dieu.
That shows that we are really being kingdom minded.
Cela montre qu'on est vraiment dans la pensée du royaume de Dieu.
Today God is calling our attention.
Et aujourd'hui le Seigneur nous appelle.
That beyond
eye service. Au-delà du service,
beyond just activities,
au-delà des activités,
he wants us to really, really know that our main existence, the reason why he created us, is to call us back to himself.
Il veut que nous puissions comprendre que la raison pour laquelle nous avons été créés,
and if you don't have the mind of, if you are not mindful of where you are going to,
et si nous ne sommes pas conscients d'où nous sommes en train de partir,
it will be difficult to prepare for the place.
Il sera très difficile de se préparer pour l'endroit.
If like now I'm going back to my country,
c'est comme si par exemple,
but I'm not preparing. I'm not thinking of how I will survive there. I'm not thinking of what will I be doing. I've been in China for quite a number of years. What is the next thing to do? I'm only thinking of China.
I'm not facing reality.
It doesn't show that I have where I'm going at heart. So God is telling us that enough of activities on earth.
Donc le Seigneur,
enough of not being mindful of where we are going to.
Le Seigneur nous demande de ne pas
because être. The essence of He even creating us is not for us to be permanently here on earth. We are aliens here on earth. It is not our permanent residence.
Nous sommes ici en tant que des voyageurs.
So there is every reason for us to have where we are going at heart.
Donc il y a une raison pour laquelle nous devons avoir ce.
So God is calling us that we need to be kingdom minded. We need to be heavenly minded. Maybe so far to have been engrossed only with activities. God is calling our attention this morning that even beyond building the lives of these children, our own lives has to be built. What is then the kingdom of God? He said we should be mindful, we should have the kingdom of God at heart. What is this kingdom of God? I'm going to read from two translations, the New KJV and the Amplified Bible. Romans chapter 14 verse 17, which is actually our textual source for today. It says, for the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. For he who serves Christ in these things is acceptable to God and approved by men. I want to read the Amplified version. After all,
le royaume de Dieu,
the kingdom of God is not a matter of getting the food and drink one likes,
c'est pas une question de nourriture, de boisson.
But instead, it is righteousness, That state which makes a person acceptable to God. And adds peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. He who serves Christ in this way is acceptable and pleasing to God. And is approved by men.
Said
the kingdom of God is not a matter of food and drink.
It
is not what we eat. It is not when we gather and say, oh, this person, that if you want to do surprise birthday, we'll go to a park, we'll go to a restaurant, people will sing, we'll pray there. It's just for the kingdom of God. No, he said it is not about food and drink. It is not about those things that are not important. Those trivial things that we are esteem actually rather than the word of the kingdom of God. No wonder when Jesus came. And there was a particular day, the Bible said Jesus was hungry. And the disciples went to get food for him. But before they came back, they already met him talking with the Samaritan woman at the well. He didn't even remember the food he told them to go and buy. And the disciples were actually surprised. Was this man not tell us he was hungry when we went to get his food? How come we came and did not even show any interest in the food? But what did he tell them in John chapter 4? He said, my food is to do the will of the Father. It is not this trivial things of earth that we esteem. Jesus was, throughout Jesus' ministry on earth, he was preaching the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says John the Baptist was in the wilderness. He was eating locusts and honey. How many of us can survive that? Even locusts and honey through our lives. You only need to be eating bread. And even bread is better than locusts and honey. Do we know locusts? And that is what he was in the wilderness. And the Bible says what he did, what he kept on saying was, repent for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent for the kingdom of God is at hand. So the kingdom of God goes beyond those trivial things that we capitalize on. It is not those things that we like. They say the food we like and the drink we like. Not those things you like to do. The kingdom of God is not something that comes easily. It is something you have to struggle. You have to. The Bible says, since the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and only the violence take it by force. You notice the two words, violence and force. Those who are violent, they have to even exercise force before you can take it. So the kingdom of God is not something that you just get cheaply, something that you just, I want to eat now, I'm hungry, and then quickly make noodles. The disciples, when they were waiting for the Holy Spirit, in the upper room, the Bible said they were there for 40 days. So are we trying to say that it is not possible for God to give Holy Spirit within 2 days of their gathering? Why did they have to wait for 40 days? Because the kingdom of God is not something trivial. When Jesus was to start his ministry, the Bible says he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. That was what launched him into his ministry. And he has told disciples that the cup that I drink, you will drink also. And the disciples couldn't start the ministry until they also waited in the upper room for 40 days. Just like Jesus fasted for 40 days. It was after that waiting on God for 40 days that they received the Holy Spirit that launched them forth into the ministry. And it was thereafter they were able to preach the kingdom of God. You want to tell me that after Jesus left, everything about kingdom of God has gone with him? But they had to wait, they had to tarry. Meaning the kingdom of God is not trivial, it is not those little things that we count. I come to church on Sunday, I go to Bible study, I have friends in church, I take picture, I take selfie with my friends. When I hit China, I'll be looking at their face. No, that's not the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God, it is not those things we like to do. The Bible says, but instead it is righteousness.
La Bible dit c'est la justice.
righteousness,
la justice,
a state which makes a person acceptable to God,
cet état qui rend une personne acceptable par Dieu,
a state which makes a person acceptable to God,
cet état qui rend une personne acceptable par Dieu.
Living according to the will of God, living according to the word of God, living that kind of life that is acceptable before God. Because God actually wants us to start living eternity from here.
He
wants us to bring His kingdom to here. He
said
it is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. The kingdom of heaven is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit.
Le royaume du ciel, c'est paix et joie.
Verse 16 says, he who serves Christ in this way is acceptable and pleasing to God.
En continuant, celui qui sert de cette façon est acceptable.
So today God is challenging us to check our lives. What which way have we been serving God that is not acceptable to Him, that you think is acceptable?
Donc aujourd'hui, le Seigneur nous met au défi de voir dans notre vie.
Have you been serving righteously? Or eye service? Have you been serving Him in a way that is acceptable before Him and pleasing before Him? Have you been pursuing peace?
Est-ce que tu as cherché la paix?
Because this is actually the kingdom of God.
Parce que
it is righteousness.
C'est la justice.
It is peace.
C'est la paix.
And it is joy in the Holy Spirit.
C'est la joie dans le Saint-Esprit.
So like I was saying, that John the Baptist preached the kingdom of heaven, not church.
Et donc Jean-Baptiste a prêché le royaume de Dieu.
Kingdom of God is not about going to preach so that the prayer itself can be, can have overflowing outside, even have canopy outside, and have
three services.
That is not the kingdom of heaven. Having 3,000 congregants does not mean the kingdom of heaven is in that
church.
When you have an heart to preach to somebody, to win a soul, to populate the kingdom of God, not because of your church. That shows that we are being kingdom minded.
Et cela montre
it is not being WISF minded. It is not when you just gave your life to Christ yesterday and tomorrow you are also, you have now become a father in the Lord. And you to start having spiritual sons and spiritual daughters. Meanwhile, you have not even groomed yourself. You have not grown to the level. You that you are still supposed to become spiritual son or spiritual daughter. You have started having spiritual mother and daughter. God bless you, my daughter. I see you doing well for the Lord. I see you, what I can see. I see a great giant in you. That is not having the kingdom of God at heart. The kingdom of heaven is not about ministry. When the disciples of John, when they came to Jesus, and they wanted to join him to become his disciple. Oh, you know that if I have a church now, brother, by the way, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm thinking about the message. My name is Adele, I'm from Nigeria. And my brother is Brother Joseph from Ivory Coast. I'm sorry. Okay, so for example, if I have a church now, and he also has a church, and by the reason of my preaching, I win people from his church to my church, will I chase them away? I will be happy that my church is getting bigger. I'm having branches. I have one in Jaya. I have one in Benjin. I have one. Our mother in the Lord is coming, visiting us. That is not the kingdom of heaven. When the disciples of John, when they came to Jesus, they wanted to join him. Of course, Jesus should have been happy, that my disciples are getting, they are increasing in number. But the Bible said, Jesus chased them back. Go and meet your master. Because he understood the concept of the kingdom of heaven. Matthew chapter 3 verse 3 says, in those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. That was the message of John in the wilderness. He did not say, repent and come and join my church. Somebody that would even say, I am just a foreigner. You can see the mind of somebody who is kingdom minded. He said, you have seen me, but I am just a foreigner. There is somebody coming behind me. Who is greater than
mine?
Whose shoes this? I can't touch.
He
was not unhappy when Jesus came and it was like Jesus was having more disciples, more followers than me. He didn't say, but I started this ministry before you. How come you're having more disciples than mine? Prophecy has gone ahead before I was God, just like you. So what's the difference? That is somebody who is kingdom minded. And when Jesus also started his ministry, the Bible says Jesus began to preach and say, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." Jesus was so consumed with the matter of the kingdom that even after he died and resurrected and he appeared to his disciples, all the while when he was still on earth before he showed himself to the Father. The Bible says after his resurrection, he was seen by his disciples for 40 days, during which he spoke of the things pertaining to the kingdom of heaven. So that means Jesus had the kingdom of heaven at heart. It is our main reason why God created us. Not to come to earth to eat, not to shop on Taobao, so that today we hear blue on blue, green on green, red on yellow, color on gold. No, that is not kingdom of heaven.
Donc le royaume de Dieu n'a pas de principal plan de l'avoir ce n'est pas de faire des bêtises.
Today I will wear a nice suit. Tomorrow I will wear tuxedo. Next month I will wear used bow tie. Oh, this is that the church must notice me. That is not the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is where we are actually, whatever we do, even in our dressing, it is for the advancement of the kingdom of God. Whatever we do, whatever we say, our reaction, our relationship with people, whether believers or unbelievers, it is toward the advancement of the kingdom of God. And when Jesus was also leaving the earth, he commanded his disciples that in this way that I have started, the kingdom of God must be what must be in your message, no matter how little the message is. Even if you want to encourage somebody, if you want to preach a message that is about prosperity, it must lead people to the kingdom of God. Whatever message you are preaching, it must point people to the kingdom of God. That's our obligation on earth. So now, how can you evaluate yourself? How mindful of the kingdom of God have you been since you gave your life to Christ? Can you really say of a truth, I have been mindful of the kingdom of God? I really have this thing at heart. Even in my research, it is showing that I am kingdom minded. Amen.
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 God is calling our attention this afternoon.
Le Seigneur nous appelle ce soir.
That He has placed these children in our hands.
It
is not only the responsibility of the parents or the teachers.
Ce n'est pas seulement la
responsibility of every one of us. There's an adage in my country that says, two pair of eyes give birth to a child. Two pair of eyes, the parents and the both parents. But we have over 200 peers that takes care of the child. So that means it's not only the responsibility of maybe the teacher, the Sunday school teacher, or the parent that should take care of the children. If a child is hairy beside you, I say, as long as it's not my family member, as long as
I'm not here,
then it doesn't concern me. We are not expanding the kingdom of God. If we see somebody who is kingdom minded, who has the kingdom of God at heart, somebody who is kingdom minded, how do we know such a person? Number one, the person will seek for the kingdom of God. It should be the priority. The Bible says you seek first, try. If you read the Amplified Bible, it says try, aim at the kingdom of God. What is acceptable before God? And then all that things will be added. Such a life will portray Jesus. It will show that Jesus is living in such a person. The person will take delight in doing God's will. And we have to bring the order to the knowledge of Christ. Paul says, because we know the terror of God, we persuade men. You know the meaning of persuasion. I want you to give your life to Christ. I'm still persuading you. There's a church in my country that is really good at that. If they have been saying, want to invite you for a program, you keep giving excuses. If they have a program by 5 p.m., they'll be at your house by 4 p.m. If you say, but I want to fetch water, they say, don't worry, we'll go and help you, they will help you fetch water. If you say, but I still need to wash my plate, they say, don't worry, we'll wash it. To get, they will do everything. When you are, you know, it's just like when the parable that Jesus said, somebody came in the middle of the night and was knocking at the door of a friend. Please give me food, I have it. So when the person did not answer, when he was being persistent, she would be forced to open. Exactly. When they are able to do all the chores that you have to do, you'll be forced to take follow them to church. And in the process, maybe it is that day that God is waiting for your soul to be delivered. So Paul says we persuade men because we know the terror of God. So being kingdom minded shows that he is somebody who helps to bring others to the knowledge of Christ. Such a person will not be conformed to the things of this world. We will not be, separated from the things of this world. Even though we are living in the world, we will know that we are not of this world. We have a place that we are going. Such a person will be a kingdom builder. I want to speak on our children on this part. We'll be a kingdom builder. We have to build the life of these children. Because the Bible says, the kingdom of heaven are actually theirs. You can see how important they are in the presence of God. I'm sure that in heaven, children, we have a special seat. Because the Bible says the kingdom of God is for them. Who is a children teacher ministry is a special person, you know? Even if you are saying you are three children, 17 teachers, don't mind them. As long as even if it is only one child that is in that ministry, that child is, you have won that child over for God. You have gained that soul for the kingdom of heaven. It is more important than when we have hundreds of children and they don't know Jesus. Such a person will be a kingdom builder. Somebody who takes delight in building others. We understand that we are just sojourners on earth. Our stay on earth is temporary. Hence, we will give it eternity in view. Because we have a mission to fulfill here on earth. Our God creating us on earth has a purpose. We have a mission to fulfill. Heaven is our home. Heaven is the head of our race. We are just passerby. We are just passerby on earth. This is not our terminal station. So as a person, as an individual, can you ask yourself, have I been fulfilling my mission on earth? Do you even know why you were created on earth? Some of us are here in China, we are in one specifically. We don't know why. Why did God bring me to this place? What mission am I supposed to fulfill? Why am I here at this point in time? Why did I not come to China a year later? Why did I not come a few years past? Why am I here at this particular time? Which life? How many lives does God want me to affect? How many lives does God want me to impact? How many lives does God want me to build? We have a mission on earth to fulfill. Otherwise, maybe after Jesus, God would have sent Jesus immediately, Adam and Eve hid in the garden. He might not have waited for a long time before he sent Jesus. But because he knows that each and every one of us has a purpose, we have a mission to fulfill before he calls us back to himself. So we have to think, well, am I fulfilling my mission on earth? As a kingdom builder, what is the level of my building? Are you still at the foundation level? Some of us have not even dug our foundation at all, let alone building it. Our land is still bushy. We have not plowed it. Let alone starting the foundation. Let alone building the house. So you have to. God is calling us to a reasoning this afternoon. As kingdom builders, that have mission to fulfill on earth.
Et en tant que des personnes qui ont une mission à remplir sur la terre.
That have lives of people to build.
En tant que des personnes qui doivent.
Have you even built your own life? Complete of building somebody's life. Since you said you have given your life to Christ, how much have you grown? What is your level of growth in Christ now? It is not about how long you have given your life to Christ. It is not the number of years that shows you are a kingdom candidate. It is not the number of years that shows you are a kingdom member. How impactful have you been?
Comment as-tu impacté la vie des gens dans l'avancement du
royaume? Like I said, it's not your ministry, it's not your activities in the church.
Parce que
j'ai dit
que c'est pas ta vie dans le royaume.
It is not your paying of tithes.
Ce n'est pas quand tu payes tes dîmes.
It is not how you show care and concern to people.
Ce n'est pas comment tu.
Even though all these things are part of it, but it is not the main thing. The Bible says it is not what we like doing.
Même si ces choses font partie de cela, mais ce n'est pas la chose principale.
It is not what we like doing. Like it is not what is easy to do, like food and drink.
La Bible dit, c'est pas
if I want to drink water now, even if I cannot walk, thank God for our ushers in this church.
He says,
we are called to serve. And I just sit and say, please get me a cup of water.
Tu peux demander à tout instant.
That is not, the kingdom of God is not as easy as that.
Et le royaume de Dieu, c'est pas aussi facile que cela.
It is living a life of righteousness.
C'est une vie de justice.
Righteous living is not something that comes handy. It's something that you have to be determined to do. Because we are living in this world and we have a lot of things that will distract us.
So
our main hate is eternity.
The not principal objective
anymore. We should be able to live eternity here from here on earth.
Nous devons être capables de vivre.
We should be able to bring the kingdom of God to earth.
La portée du royaume de Dieu sur la terre.
I pray God will help us in Jesus'
name.
So we are on earth to fulfill a mission.
Donc nous sommes sur la terre pour remplir une mission.
We are on earth to fulfill a mission.
Nous sommes sur la terre pour remplir une mission.
I am concluding.
Et je conclue.
As a kingdom-minded person,
et une personne avec la
we should understand that we are being called to build, to be kingdom builders.
Nous devons comprendre que nous sommes appelés
à être
bâtisseurs
du royaume. And we should live our life in the context.
Alors nous devons mener nos vies
en eternal purposes of God.
Avec les plans éternels de Dieu.
Somebody who has a mission, somebody who has another home in view.
Quelqu'un qui a une autre maison en ce moment.
Somebody who knows that the race is not for this place.
Quelqu'un qui sait que la course n'est pas.
No matter the enjoyment you find here, no matter the hardship, no matter the tribulation, no matter the peace and joy, no matter how wealthy you are here, it's not the end of our journey. We have somewhere we are going, and that is the kingdom of God. That is the kingdom of heaven. If you are not mindful of this, if you don't have peace of mind, we will just continue living our lives here as if this place has no end. As if this is the main reason why we are created. If a student does not have exam at heart, if there is no exam at the end of the semester, even, that's why there is an exam. We still have students who doesn't go to class regularly. So now, let's say there is no exam. The Chinese government just say, just come. There's nothing to do. So as kingdom-minded person, there is something that should be pursuing us, which is the kingdom of God. Which is the kingdom of heaven. And we strive, let us strive to enter. We strive to enter. It is not an easy road. It's something you strive, you aim at. A deliberate action. Something you propose your heart to do. So God is calling us today that we should have the kingdom of God in heaven. I mean, doing what is acceptable before God at heart. That is the only way, that is the only thing to show to us that we are living a life that is living
God.
As we are celebrating our children today, and as we are celebrating every one of us being children of God, if indeed you are a child of God, you have God at heart. And God is the King of the kingdom, right? So if you are indeed a child of the kingdom, we have the owner of the kingdom at heart. So today God is calling us, we have to be mindful of He who is the owner of the kingdom.
Donc tu dois te concentrer sur lui,
which is God. So we have the kingdom of heaven and earth. I pray the Lord will bless our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's be on our feet as well. We'll be praying for ourselves. I'll pray one prayer for the children as well. I want us to pray and tell God that Lord, search me through and through. Is there any way I'm not serving you in a way that is acceptable and pleasing? Maybe I've just only been engrossed in activities. My service to you has not been to the advancement of the kingdom. We know yourself, and God also knows you. Even if you think you are active and you are serving God, but God knows you. So God, please open my eyes to see. Let me know. Let my heart be open to see where I've head away from advancing your kingdom. Where I've actually not, I believe we already prayed, where I've actually not been serving you as I ought to do. Where I've actually not been serving in an acceptable way. Where I've actually not been pursuing in your kingdom. Where I've actually not been living a righteous life. Where I've actually not been living an acceptable life. Oh God, open my eyes to you this afternoon. And help me to make amends. Help me to live my life in a way that is pleasing to you. In a way that shows that I'm indeed kingdom minded. Help my life, oh God, to be centered. Everything that pertains to my living, everything that pertains to my existence, let it be centered towards the kingdom of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, help our life this day, oh God, that as you have called us, oh God, to a reason, as you have called us, oh God, to meet together with you, as you have come to enlighten our hearts, oh God, that not just coming to church, not just being religious, is what is called the kingdom of heaven. Jesus, we ask this day, oh God, that you open our eyes to see. Help us to know, in the name of Jesus, we indeed pursue the kingdom of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we receive this grace, oh God, to be kingdom minded, to have the kingdom of heaven at hand, in the name of Jesus. The kingdom of God is at hand. Father, help us to fulfill our mission here on earth, to fulfill our purpose, in the mighty name of Jesus. Your name, oh God, we thank you for our children today that you are celebrating. We thank you for their lives as they grow. They shall continue to know you, oh God. They are curious, Father, oh God. Some of them, they are really curious to know you. We have that you continue to plant in their hearts to know you, oh God, to know you more and more in your name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, oh God, Heavenly Father. We thank you for your word that you have spoken to us. Show that we have eternity in view. Blessed be your name, O God.